showing a significant drop in the number of assaults and cops and cops.
Our next guest is somebody who you could probably say he's made the clarinet cool. He does a bit of modelling. He's a good-looking young man. He's Austrian. He's here, and I want to play the first track of his album, Portraits, because this will knock your socks off. This is Andreas Ottensamer. Absolutely fantastic. Here it is.
You guys have a seat. Just tell me here.
All right. Thank you.
I grew up in a family really full of musicians. My parents being both musicians. My father is principal clarinet with the Vienna Philharmonic, my brother as well, so they're colleagues. And my mother teaches cello at the conservatory in Vienna. So yeah, music was all around from the very first day of my life. And just very natural to be surrounded by music. And of course, Vienna itself, the city is a metropole of music. You have music everywhere, the Vienna State Opera, the Musikverein, the Vienna Philharmonic Orchestra, the Opera Orchestra, so it's really a city full of music. I started with the piano, which I think is a very good thing to do at such an early age. And that's how I kind of, you know, got near myself to making music, had my first experiences, impressions. And then at a certain age, I wanted to try something else or to add a new instrument, which was the cello first. And then with 12, I thought, okay, I want to try my luck with the clarinet as well, which was kind of logical at some point that I would try this instrument as, you know, my father and my brother were playing the same instrument. So just trying it was, I think, very obvious for me. But then sticking with it was a whole different decision. Well, as soon as I started the clarinet, we tried to find pieces we could perform together with my father and my brother, the three of us. And then pretty soon we formed trio, so the clarinets it's called. And well, you know, we at first we didn't think anybody would really want to hear what we play, as probably three clarinets is quite boring for an audience. But nowadays we still perform quite a lot throughout the world, and we have found a big variety of pieces we can put together as a concert program. It's actually my second time in Sydney, and I've got the chance to explore the city a lot, I would say, because I came here a few days earlier to just, you know, spend some time here. It's a beautiful city, I think. Playing with an orchestra is the Berlin Philharmonic. Is a dream of, I would say, any musician who wants to become an orchestra musician. This orchestra is going to be on top of any list, or among the top of any orchestras. So really, I'm really happy I can be playing, I can be part of this ensemble. Recording an album is something. Is again an entirely new world, and quite different from everything you do as a musician. Apart from that, I feel it's important to still have this live concert feeling, and that's why I was really thankful that with this first album, Portraits, we could do the recording in the actual concert hall of the Rotterdam Philharmonic Orchestra, with their chief conductor, of course, which is amazing in combination, Yannick Nezizaga, because it's just so much more productive if, you know, the two partners know each other for a very long time. They know, the conductor knows exactly how to work with the orchestra and what they need, and the orchestra knows what he wants. So I just, you know, drop in and everything's great. So that was quite good for me. This promotion stuff and everything around the new CD has just started for me, so it's very new, it's very exciting. I'm trying to do my best to you know, satisfy the questions and all the promotional requests, but it's fun. It's really nice to get around and have the possibility to present what you love to do and to get people be interested in what you just recorded or in what you're gonna do or to see concerts. So yeah, I enjoyed it very much. So we're here for the masterclass at the Sydney Conservatory in the nice hall, in the big hall. There's five students participating at the masterclass, and they will be playing some concertos, some Mozart concerto, some pieces from my album, the Spohr Concerto, Copland Concerto. So yeah, looking forward to that. Well, masterclasses in classical music are a great chance for people, not only for students, but also for the person giving the masterclass, to just share knowledge or share experiences with certain pieces. Also, you know, the point of views, no matter where you come, it's so different to you know, to approach a piece or to approach music in general. So it's always very interesting for me as well to see what's different in no matter country where you're just at the moment. So I did some master classes in Japan before, or in Seoul, and now here in Sydney. So it's going to be totally different, I'm sure. And it's a big challenge to, you know, you have a very limited time, and you want to give something to the person you're working with. You want to give him something he can work with later, he can gain from. So I hope I can live up to that.
Basically, it's a workshop. And everybody performs for about, or they play a 5 or 10 minute piece, and then it gets workshopped and we go over it bit by bit, just like you would in a lesson, but in a public forum, so that everybody can sort of pick up on what's going on. And it's a fantastic learning experience for everybody watching as well as everybody playing. You're a lot more exposed, and the focus is all on you, whereas in an orchestra it might be on somebody else, and you can't hide as much, obviously. So it's quite stressful, but it's fun as well.
Before you start, try to have an imagination of what you want to, like, you know, probably you know how the piece goes, so try to imagine what's the mood, what's the atmosphere, and what kind of atmosphere you want to create. Mm-hmm. So from the first moment on, it's just, you know, in this very mood you're imagining, yeah? Just try.
We talked a lot about the mood of the pieces, so I played the Mozart concerto, and it's one of the staples of our repertoire and on basically every single audition that we do. So, yeah, just the characters and things and development and articulation and things.
So sometimes giving masterclasses or teaching is kind of awkward for me because I'm sometimes younger than the students playing for me. So I really try not to be like a teacher kind of person, but just share what, you know, share what I experienced with the piece or what my approach would be. A little bit, probably a little bit more fluent. So it has just one line. It's for me a little bit too much, bits by bits. Yeah. Let's try it once more.
A massive hype here at the con about him coming, and it has been so for months. So we've been all really looking forward to this masterclass, and it's really lived up to what we all wanted it to be. Hi everyone, I'm Sandra. To mix things up a little bit, I'll be playing some orchestral excerpts. It's actually audition season right now, so I thought it would be really handy actually to play him some of my orchestral excerpts and get a new view on, you know, articulations and things like that to help me in my auditions.
Orchestral excerpts are a big part of a musician's life if you want to be an orchestral musician, because this is what an orchestra is going to want to hear if you're taking an audition. So this is something really important for any student to work on. Being now an orchestral musician, I've gone through that process, and I'm looking forward to helping students kind of, it's very difficult because you have a very limited time of a huge piece, like for example, Beethoven 6 or Dances of Galanta. I mean, you know, it's like, what, 45 minutes or whatever, at least long. And you're playing probably 1 minute or 2 minutes.
Try to also develop the long notes, right?
Okay.
Either lead them to the next take them away a little bit so it's not too stuck.
Kind of, okay.
Yeah, just once more. And really imagine before it's a huge orchestra thing and then suddenly you come out of nowhere, clarinet solo, bam. Careful not to enter with an accent, right? It can be loud and soloistic without entering with an accent, right?
Yeah.
And use this effect that you're forte here and piano there, right?
Okay.
So don't take the surprise, right?
Okay.
And the fast notes really raise to the next bar, right? This is probably what I mean. Now the two staccato notes are too much connected to the first note and not connected to the other
okay.
note. So try to really.
He gave me so many tips on articulations because it's really, you can play it so many different ways, and just to get his expertise on that, and he's obviously played it multiple times with orchestras, and it was just so handy. So that was really nice for him to be able to tell me, because he has such different views than other people, particularly this one. He had a bit of a different interpretation than I did, but it's always so good to get different people's interpretations of things so I can mold them together and make my own. So yeah, it was wonderful.
The Yellow Lounge is a great thing. I enjoyed that very much, and I'm looking forward to presenting the album a little bit in a very loungy atmosphere, so if you can say that. It's great to just be performing, other people are having drinks. Probably I would like to have some drinks too, but maybe just after the performance.
Well, we just had the Yellow Lounge, the last event here in Sydney. I think it was great, really a great experience, a great atmosphere, so many people, and I enjoyed it very much. The audience was great. I hope they enjoyed it a lot. It seemed like they did. What I always like about Yellow Lounge is that it's so close, it's so interactive. You know, you talk to the audience as well, not just playing. I played an encore for the Yellow Lounge. It was the Monty Cha Dash. I kind of didn't want to leave the stage without playing that, as I'm half Hungarian. So I wanted to kind of pay tribute to that side. And it's always fun to play that. It's a great piece, very effectful. So if you need an extra round of applause, it's always good.